No doubt, the appearance of a dragonborn at this time is not an accident. Your destiny is surely bound up with the return of the dragons. You should focus on honing your voice, and soon your path will be made clear. There is indeed much that we know that you do not. That does not mean that you are ready to understand it. Do not let your easy mastery of the voice tempt you into the arrogance of power. That has been the downfall of many dragonborn before you. Dragons have the inborn ability to learn and project their voice. Dragons also are able to absorb the power of their slain brethren. A few mortals are born with similar abilities, whether a gift or a curse has been a matter of debate down through the centuries. What you have already learned in a few days took even the most gifted of us years to achieve. Some believe that dragonborn are sent into the world by the gods at times of great need. We will speak more of that later, when you are ready. Dragons have always been able to shout. Language is intrinsic to their very being. There is no difference in the dragon tongue between debating and fighting. Shouting comes as naturally to a dragon as breathing or speaking. In mythic times, when mortal kind was in great need, the goddess Kinnereth granted us the ability to speak as dragons do. For most people, long years of training are required to learn even the simplest shout. But for you, the dragon speech is in your blood, and you learn it almost without effort.
Five. Our leader, Partanax, lives alone on the peak of the throat of the world. When your voice can open the path, you will know you are ready to speak to him.
As I said, you will know you are ready when your voice can open the path to him. We study the way of the voice according to the teachings of our founder, Jürgen Windcaller. Very few are permitted to study with us here at High Hrothgar. But in your case, Dragonborn, it is a privilege to guide you towards mastery of your voice. He was a great war leader of the ancient Nords, a master of the voice, or tongue. After the disaster at Red Mountain, where the Nord army was annihilated, he spent many years pondering the meaning of that terrible defeat. He finally came to realize that the gods had punished the Nords for their arrogant and blasphemous misuse of the voice. He was the first to understand that the voice should be used solely for the glory and worship of the gods, not the glory of men. Jürgen Windcaller's mastery of the voice eventually overcame all opposition, and the way of the voice was born. The voice was a gift of the goddess Kinnereth at the dawn of time. She gave mortals the ability to speak as dragons do. Although this gift has often been misused, the only true use of the voice is for the worship and glory of the gods. True mastery of the voice can only be achieved when your inner spirit is in harmony with your outward actions. In the contemplation of the sky, Kinnereth's domain, and the practice of the voice, we strive to achieve this balance. The Dragonborn is an exception to all the rules. The dragon blood itself is a gift of the gods. If we accept one gift, how can we deny the other? As Dragonborn, you have received the ability to shout directly from Akatosh. We therefore seek to guide you on the proper use of your gift, which transcends the restrictions which bind other mortals. Sky, guard you.
Oh, what is it?
I am, actually.
Now, I might have felt a bit nervous, just a bit, but I've seen you in action, so I'm pretty confident we'll do great.
In a dungeon full of drama,
between your thume and my magic, we could tackle just about any foe. Likewise. Let's get moving, mighty hero.
Well, well, well. Dragonborn. Now with the Greybeard's seal of approval and a bunch of shiny mystical powers to boot. Do you have any idea how exciting this is for me? To be able to study the thume up close and with such regularity. I must write this all up. No other scientist in Tamriel has this kind of opportunity. Let's go.
The Greybeards have taught you well, and you are a quick learner. Now you are louder and faster than ever.
Let you really gotta hand it to the divines. And truly is beautiful.
You there? You're the one they call Dragonborn. Your lies fall on deaf ears, deceiver. The true Dragonborn comes. You are but his shadow. When Lord Mirak appears, all shall bear witness. None shall stand to oppose him.
Ah, good to see you again. How'd that delivery go? Quite a climb, wasn't it? Anyway, much appreciated. Here, take this for your troubles. Thanks again for the legwork.
I've been trying to find the right moment.
Something.
Here.
Smell here. Let's try to handle this quickly.
Yeah, this place seems great.
Ustengrav, party capital of Skyrim.
Looks like we're here. Let's get to it, shall we?
It's horrendous.
Smell here. Let's try to handle this quickly.
Who's there? Do you burn?
Take this.
smell here. Let's try to handle this quickly.
This place seems great.
Ustengrath, part... capital of Skyrim.
Oh wait, my mistake. It's horrendous.
Looks like we're here. Let's get to it, shall we?
I can smell magic and death, but no horns so far. I wonder how valuable the horn is. Maybe the Greybeards will let you keep it. We deserve a reward for suffering this place. Survival isn't.
I was always taught to avoid these types of ruins. I think I see why now.
outside of you. Looks like we're making some progress here. I certainly do hope this is all worth it. This ruin is rather sprawling and a bit confusing at times. Ugh. Let's keep moving though. I can't wait to get out of here.
I wonder if the horn is made of gold. I bet it is very pretty.
Maybe. All right, let's do it.
Succeeding at life is harder than achieving death, especially when we are around. Wouldn't you rather relax in a nice inn? Come on, let us go. Thank you.
So, where are we off to now? Be a good guide for this old
Well, relic. That was an anticlimax. What does the note say? And presumably that someone has this horn the Greybeards are so desperate for you to fetch them. How very mysterious. Shall we go and see? Bye for now. Excuse me.
Well, that was rather anticlimactic. If we are done wasting time, let us get out of this place. I have your back, my friend.
Oh? What is it?
Stupid tomb.
Don't we have more important things to worry about?
At the end of it all. What a waste of time.
Ready when you are. Isn't it wonderful? We trudge through this sprawling burrow, face mortal peril every turn, solve deadly puzzles, and what reward awaits us? A scrap of paper with someone's scrawls? What a fascinating learning experience. And the worst part is, why not just send a note like any sane person would? Why make us plod through the whole damn tomb? Did they think it'd be funny? Or was it some kind of test? I'll help to express your immense disappointment, that is. I hope we can make sense of this nonsense when we find the author of this note. Let's get moving. Never saw anything like this back on the island. I'm so glad I left that place.
May the gods watch over your battles, friend.
What? Blades, helmets, pretty much anything to suit your needs.
I hope you like it. It's a special thing for you.
There you go. Are you up for a bit of rhyming?
Sure.
You looking.
But let us be careful.
Blades, helmets, pretty much anything to suit your needs.
You're not serious.
You're a
fucking sure I am. We got some furs and tree branches, paint them white, and then tie them to stone. Instant fr-
Indeed. The world is a crazy place, but there's usually a silver lining.
Welcome. Let me know if you want anything. Think I got a clean mug around here.
You're that visitor been poking around.
The context of these words I am combining.
Attic room,
Barkeep.
Eh?
I can see that.
I'd like a
well, we don't have an attic room, but you can have the one on the left. Make yourself
like
at home.
Drink.
Very good.
Of course.
Thank you. Hang on, are you sure you didn't let me win just to put me in a good mood?
Listen, Lucien, I would have beaten you if I could.
Well, we're here. Now where's this friend of yours?
Excuse me, my friend.
Don't speak of this.
So you're the Dragonborn I've been hearing so much about. I think you're looking for this. We need to talk. Follow me.
I have to say, I'm rather surprised at how much the adventurer life seems to be growing on me. Exciting things tend not to happen to the Flavius family. Not many of us, anyway. I mean, Mother fought in the Great War, granted, and then of course there was old Octavius way back in the Second Era. But the rest of us tend to live really quite unremarkable lives. I'm rather chuffed to be the odd one out. Ha! Well, you're not wrong there. But thank you, I appreciate the sentiment, however vacuously true it may be.
You're not afraid of me, are you?
Oh, well now you're making me blush. Thank you, my friend. That means a lot. Let's get back to it.
I am glad you finally got that horn. Those greybeards had better
yes.
be grateful.
Okay.
What's next?
Close the door.
If loving you was a crime, I'd be guilty as charged.
Now we can talk. The Greybeards seem to think you're the Dragonborn. I hope they're right. Surprised? I guess I'm getting pretty good at my harmless innkeeper act.
The big questions in life. Or is it? Discuss?
You can't be too careful. Thalmor spies are everywhere. It was the only way I could make sure it wasn't a Thalmor trap. I am not your enemy. I already gave you the horn. I'm actually trying to help you. I just need you to hear me out. I'll explain what I want when I want. Got it? You'd already be dead if I didn't like the look of you when you walked in here. But I had to know if the rumors about you were true. I'm part of a group that's been looking for you. Well, someone like you, for a very long time. If you really are Dragonborn, that is. Before I tell you any more, I need to make sure I can trust you. I knew the Greybeards would send you there if they thought you were Dragonborn. They're nothing if not predictable. When you showed up here, I knew you were the one the Greybeards sent, and not some Thalmor plant. We remember what most don't, that the Dragonborn is the ultimate dragon slayer. You're the only one that can kill a dragon permanently by devouring its soul. Can you do it? Can you devour a dragon's soul? Good. And you'll have a chance to prove it to me soon enough. Yes. We're very old enemies. And if my suspicions are correct, they might have something to do with the dragons returning. But that isn't important right now. What is important is that you might be dragonborn. Dragons aren't just coming back. They're coming back to life. They weren't gone somewhere for all these years. They were dead, killed off centuries ago by my predecessors. Now something's happening to bring them back to life, and I need you to help me stop it. I know they are. I visited their ancient burial mounds and found them empty. And I figured out where the next one will come back to life. We're going to go there, and you're going to kill that dragon. If we succeed, I'll tell you anything you want to know. You should know. You got the map for me from Bleak Falls Barrow. The Dragonstone was a map of ancient dragon burial sites. I've looked at which ones are now empty. The pattern is pretty clear. It seems to be spreading from the southeast, down in the Geralds near Riften. The one at Kynesgrove is next, if the pattern holds. Kynesgrove, there's an ancient dragon burial near there. If we can get there before it happens, maybe we'll learn how to stop it. I need to get into my traveling gear. Give me a minute and I'll be ready.
So, it turns out this friend was none other than Delphine.
That's better.
That's a relief.
Let's get on the road to Kynesgrove.
And she's one of the good guys. I like that. Kind of not cool for her to steal the horn and all that.
A secret spy remark.
But, hey,
I smell the
I'm all right with it now. What matters is that she doesn't harbor any evil or malicious intentions. Yes, she might be a bit prickly. But I think it'll be nice to have her on our side. Now, I think we should get going. A dragon coming back from the dead seems like a pretty big deal, to say the least.
Let us go to Kynesgrove and end that dragon. Maybe then Delphine will give you some real answers. I hope she is trustworthy.
How are you doing?
What's next?
You lie and you drink all our mead. Now I think it's high time that you lie down and bleed. And so then came clashing.
Kynesgrove is this way. We can travel together. Lit up and there, your choice.
Wow, this temple truly looks like something else.
Ah, you've retrieved the horn of Jörgen Rimkall. Well, you have now passed all the trials. Come with me. It is time for us to recognize you formally. Dragonborn. You are ready to learn the final word of unrelenting force. Down. Which means push.
Down.
With all three words together, this shout is.
Speak to you.
Not even you.
Stand between us
But boy, oh boy, you sure look very tasty at this moment.
Not funny, my friend.
Maybe I'm not kidding. Maybe I'm serious.
You're making my bones vibrate. Oh, stop it.
Tasted the voice of the Greybeards and passed through unscathed. High Hrothgar is open to you. Wind, guide you.
We spoke the traditional words of greeting to a dragonborn who has accepted our guidance. The same words were used to greet the young Talos when he came to High Hrothgar before he became the Emperor Tiber Septim.
Ah, I sometimes forget you are not versed in the dragon tongue as we are. This is a rough translation.
Long has the storm crown languished, with no worthy brow to sit upon. By our breath, we bestow it now to you, in the name of Kine, in the name of Shore, and in the name of Atmora of old. You are Ysmir now, a dragon of the north. Hearken to it.
You have learned so much already, Dragonborn. Growing your gift too quickly would be dangerous. But there are many words of power in Skyrim, carved in the dragon tongue. Even from here, we can feel the thum resonate from them. Finding these lost words would be a sufficient test to temper your abilities with experience. Ask when you are ready to search. We have felt the whisper of a word. Give me your map and I will show you where its echo can be found. Wind,